case for the strong executive rests on the fact that America is the first republic that was formed with a strong executive. Previous republics had executives who were at the bidding of the legislature or who rebelled against that, like Oliver Cromwell, and became tyrannical. So how do you make an executive that's strong enough and yet remains republican or obedient to law? Now, the difficulty is that law cannot prescribe in advance every situation that's going to arise, nor can any general principle. So you always need to rely in government on, or have a way of relying in an emergency, or maybe also even also for the long term, on a single mind who can decide without infringement or hindrance. Of course, you can make him accountable afterwards, as our president is, but there needs to be someone who's looking at the whole and who can react in the name of the whole. And that's what our constitutional executive power is. It's a power, even I think, to go against the law when the law would bring disaster, as might happen.